The tide has been the biggest thing going on, and we want to start off with that, show you what's going on. Yesterday, Monday night, we had a high tide, 4.6. It was at minor tidal flooding. Minor is 4.5 to 5.5, and we haven't been above 5.5 yet. For the morning tide today, it was at 5.2, near minor tidal flooding into the region, and then right around 5 feet for tonight at 9:30, 4.9 feet coming up by Wednesday morning. So it's still going to flood a little bit. Coming up. Now, Tropical Storm Jose, you'll note that I said Tropical Storm Jose, and that's what it is. It's dropped down below 74 miles an hour. It's right on into here, and that storm system again is moving northeastward away from us very, very slowly. The rainfall has come to an end for the most part. We could still see a stray sprinkle or two overnight, but things are moving on away. Here's what's going on with the latest on what's going on with the storm. It's weakened down to tropical storm force below 74 miles an hour, 70 mile an hour winds, moving to the northeast at 9. Where's it going? It's going nowhere fast, or going nowhere kind of slow, actually. 65 mile an hour winds coming up by Wednesday morning, 60 mile an hour winds by Wednesday evening. And then we work our way all the way into the weekend, and this thing loops back around on itself, but very, very much weaker, only about 35 mile an hour winds. With this thing still spinning out there, it's still going to hold our tide up to nuisance tidal flooding levels coming up over the weekend, all the way into the weekend. Jose and Maria, of course, Jose has weakened. We got one good tide out of it, but still, it was minor tidal flooding into the region. It'll move your car for tomorrow morning again because it could still be some minor tidal flooding into the area. Now, what's going on with Maria? It's a big one again, and this thing is making its way. It says St. John, but really it's St. Croix, and St. Croix is really going to get socked overnight, and Puerto Rico is going to get socked first thing in the morning by a Category 5 storm. Here's an enhanced satellite view. Of course, it moved on through Dominica and Guadeloupe last night, especially the northern end of Dominica. And of course, today on this side of the storm, the front, the leading edge and the eastern side of it is where the worst part of the storm is located. And look at the trajectory of that. That's going to go right on through St. Croix any minute from now. So by around midnight or shortly after midnight, St. Croix is really, really going to get socked with this storm system. And again, it says St. John. St. John is actually up into here. This is St. Croix. 175 mile an hour winds, moving to the west northwest at 10 miles an hour. 165 mile an hour winds at 8 o'clock in the morning. So it's hitting Puerto Rico. San Juan, biggest city, right on up into here. They're likely to be on the real, real close again to the eye of the storm, right into the areas in the southern portion of San Juan. 145 mile an hour winds coming up by 8 o'clock. Wednesday evening, and it's weakening on down a little bit, and then it'll continue to weaken a little bit. 140 mile an hour winds, 130 by Thursday evening. Take you on into Friday evening, 125. From there we go to Saturday, and we're looking at 120. Sunday, we're looking at 105. Now, the cone has widened out considerably by that point. Let's have a look at the forecast models and show you what's going on with those. We'll take you all the way on into Sunday evening, and they're pretty tight through here. However, after that, they spread out a little bit more. So we've got some forecast models taking it along the coastline, then on up into the Canadian Maritime provinces, and others have it hanging kind of a right and going on up into the Atlantic. It looks like it could be close by. So Jose is moving slowly on away from our part of the world. Here's what's going on with our immediate forecast overnight. Our skies clear off for the day tomorrow. It'll be in the upper 80s. Very, very nice warm day. Tide will be up, especially in the morning again, for some minor tidal flooding. This is about 3 in the afternoon, and we're looking at temperatures in the low 80s for that day. So again, very warm coming up for tomorrow. Still a good moderate, or excuse me, a solidly minor tidal flooding coming up for tomorrow morning, and then tapering off to nuisance tidal flooding after that, and a warm day tomorrow, 82 to 85 thereafter.